everyone, my name is Cassidy, also known as 1AM. So you're probably here because you're ready to get your home studio started and you're probably wondering, where do I even start? So in this video, I'm gonna keep it super simple and just give you some of the basic things that you'll need to get your home studio started. And I'll even share with you some of the gear that I use personally. Now, a lot of people tend to get hung up on computer specs, brand, and even the whole debate about PC versus Mac. But honestly, as long as you have a computer right now, that's all that matters and that's all that you'll need. It's pretty much good enough. And if you're curious about what I use a Windows PC. If you're curious about the specs of my computer, there they are. Now, if you don't have access to a computer, with technology today, it is totally possible to have a great sounding home studio with a smartphone or a tablet. There's definitely lots of apps out there that are both free and paid, both for Android and iOS. So if you don't have a computer, not to worry, this can definitely be an option to look at. Just a bonus that I want to throw in of essential gear that you might want to add to your home studio is having a dedicated external hard drive. There's different types of hard drives. There are just the regular spinning hard drive. There's SSD drives, which are a lot faster, or there's the good old USB drives. So that's definitely an essential that I want to add in there. It's not required, but it is definitely something you would want to consider, especially when creating music. Now, the second thing that you're gonna need is called an audio interface. And to keep it simple, basically what this is the link between your mic or your instrument and your computer. And there's a lot of different options out there. Some of these audio interfaces have multiple inputs. So if you're gonna be recording multiple instruments or multiple people, then I would look into that. If you're gonna be recording just you, then there's options for that as well. So keep it simple, don't overthink it. Just find one that fits your needs and fits your price range. The next thing that you're gonna need is a microphone. And the most common studio microphones are condenser mics and dynamic mics. The difference between these two microphones is basically condenser mics are more sensitive to the transients in your voice. They tend to require phantom power and they're more commonly found in professional studio settings. And on the other hand, dynamic mics tend to be less sensitive to the transients in your voice, but they're more rugged and they're more commonly used in live professional settings. Now, the next thing that you're gonna need are cables, and you're gonna wanna make sure that you have the correct cables. But more commonly, if you're using a microphone and it's a condenser or dynamic, you're gonna wanna have one of these, which is an XLR cable. And if you're using an instrument, more commonly, it is an unbalanced quarter inch cable. And I would really, really recommend that you take the time to research and understand what the difference between all these different cables are and what their intended uses are, just so you don't damage your gear. Now, after you have pretty much all the essentials that you'll need, you're gonna wanna have a good source to listen back to your audio on. Technically, you can use regular headphones that you have and or you could use the speakers on your computer, but I definitely recommend that you invest in some high quality studio monitors and or headphones. Depending on your situation, depending on your environment, you're gonna wanna pick the best option that fits your needs. Last but certainly not least, you're gonna need to choose a DAW, Digital Audio Workstation. And basically this is the software that you're gonna be using to record your audio and create your music production in. There are so many DAWs out there. There's a lot of free versions. There's a lot of paid versions. And it's really all based off preference and what's available to you based off the computer that you're using. And basically all the DAWs do the same thing. They allow you to record audio, they allow you to edit audio, and most of them allow you to create beats within the program. And that's basically all you really need to get started with your home studio. I hope this video was helpful. Make sure you leave comments if you have any questions. And there are so many different options out there, and the best practices is just go out, research, try them out, see what best fits your needs. So with that, I will say peace and love, stay creating, and until next time.